Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how 8051 program to find whether the given number is positive or negative. Okay, so if the number is positive, we'll store 00H in 30H location. If the number is negative, we'll store FFH in 30H location. Okay, so before writing the program, let's see how to implement or how to implement, for what logic we will need to write a program, means how to find out whether the number is even or positive or negative. Okay, so let's take the example as 55H itself. Okay, 55H. Okay, actually, so this is the positive number, this is the positive number, and this will be stored in the binary form. So that is 0101 0101. Okay, so it in memory it's stored in the binary form, okay, as it is. But if the number we feed it is -55H, means here minus represents it is a negative number. But when we write a binary number, binary representation, we are not going to represent whether it is a positive or negative. So usually the MSB bit is used to indicate the sign of the binary number. If the MSB bit is 1, then we call that number is a negative. If the MSB bit is 0, then the number is positive, and this we follow for signed number representation. Okay, for unsigned we don't follow this one. For signed representation we follow this, means always we use the MSB bit to represent whether the given number is positive or negative. So if we feed -55H, then this will be stored in the memory in 2's complement representation. In 2's complement representation. Okay. So now, how to find out the 2's complement representation of this 55H is, first we need to take the 1's complement of the 55H, then we need to add 1. Okay. So let's take 1's complement of 55H. So this is 55H, means 1's complement of this one we get 10101010. Then if we add 1, we get 1101010101. Okay, so let's write the hexadecimal in hexadecimal form. 1010 means it is A, and 1011 means it is B. So means if the data, if we give 55H, but in the memory, microcontroller memory, this number will be stored as A, B. Okay, so now observe here this MSB bit. So the MSB bit is 1, right? So it indicates it is a negative number. So like this, if we write this representation for any these numbers, always MSB bit will be 1 for the negative numbers and MSB bit will be 0 for the positive number. Okay, so here the logic is we need to check the MSB bit of the given number. Okay, so to find out the whether the number is positive or negative. Okay, so for that we need to separate, or we need to get this bit in the carry flag so that we can check the single bit. Okay, because entire the 8051 provides many bit manipulation instruction, but we need to take this bit from this memory location, because we don't have any memory bit manipulation instructions on the memory locations, right? So let's write a program for this. So we'll take the data in the accumulator itself. Okay, so we'll take the data in the accumulator itself. Move A comma, we'll take this number itself as minus 55, okay, minus 55, right? So now next, to take this bit in the carry flag, we can use the instruction, that is right, rotate left through carry instruction, okay, rotate left through carry instruction. So what this instruction does is it moves the MSB bit to the carry flag. It moves the MSB bit to the carry flag so that we can check using the JC instruction, that is jump if carry bit is 1. Okay, right. So first we'll rotate the contents of accumulator, that is rotate left through carry. So what this instruction, it rotates the contents of accumulator 1 bit left. Okay, this is left through the carry. Okay, so now if you take this example itself, after the execution of this instruction, the carry flag bit will have 1, and these bits will be, this will be moved to this place, and this D1 will be moved to D2, D2 will be moved to D3, and D3 will be moved to D4. So like this, one bit will be shifted towards the left. Okay, so now we'll check the carry. Okay, write this one to check this one. So what this instruction does, if the carry sets, it moves to the label target address mentioned here. So if carry is generated, means actually it is a negative number, right? So I'll write here negative itself. Okay, so if the carry flag sets, the controller jumps to the address specified in the instruction, that is negative. So here I'll write negative, right? So what if negative, what we need to do in the program, actually if it is negative, we need to store FFH in 38. So we'll move FFH in 38. #0FF. Okay, in case if the carry bit is 0, so that time this condition is failed, is nothing but the number is positive. So if it is positive, we are going to store 00H in 38. So that is done by move 30H comma #00H. When this instruction is executed, we need to skip this instruction, right? Because this instruction we need to exit only if the carry is generated. So that can be done using the unconditional jump instruction, that is sjump skip, and that we can write here sjump skip. So here I'll write sjump skip. Okay, so this is how we can write the program to check the number is positive or negative. Okay, so now let's execute the same program with the help of the kill compiler and we'll check the result. Okay, A is loaded with minus 55H. Right, so now we'll execute this program step by step. See, the first instruction we have is move A comma hash minus 55H. So now actually initially the contents of accumulator is 00H. See, now the accumulator is having 0AB. Actually in the program we have fed the data minus 55H, right? See, this is equivalent here, it is FFAB, means it is a negative number, so it is stored as a in 2's complement form, which we discussed in the starting. Okay. Right, so now we are rotating the contents of this accumulator through left through carry and check the for the carry flag also. Okay, so right, see, it is rotated, and after rotating the contents of accumulator is changed, and no need to worry about this one because just we don't need this data, right? Just we are going to check whether the number is positive or negatively. See, here the carry flag is set, means when this instruction is executed, it should move to this label, right? That is negative, where this is the sixth instruction we have. Okay, so let's see the execution. See, here it came, right? So means we
we are going to store FFH in 30H to indicate the number is negative. See, the 30H is stored with FFH. Okay, so now we'll see the same example with the positive number. Okay, I'll just delete here 50, negative number. Okay, so let's see now. Right, see now, initially accumulator is 0. See, the A is loaded with 55X. Right, so now in the 55H, the MSBBT is 0. So it is a positive number. We'll see where this goes. See, the carry is not generated here. So this instruction is fade. So if the control is executing the next instruction, which is just below this conditional instruction, so we are storing 00H in 30H, right? So after this one, we need to skip this instruction. See, the controller came to end of the probe. Okay, so this is how we can find out or to check the given number is positive or negative. Okay, so using the same logic, you can try for this program. Okay, that is, write an ALP to separate the positive and the negative numbers in a given block of data. Data are stored in the internal RAM memory location starting from 400H to 409H. Store the positive numbers starting from the internal RAM location 60H and negative numbers from the internal memory address 70H. So here what you need to do is, you need to separate the positive numbers and the negative numbers. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can reply to this, you can message